Hey, this is Daniel from AMP Motorsports. Today I'm going to be showing you how to wash a car, whether it's ceramic coated, PPF'd, or neither of the two. The first step in our wash is going to be de-ironing. So we're going to go ahead and use a de-ironing solution. Today we're going to be using BDX. This is a product from 3D Detailing. The purpose of this is to remove any kind of minerals or contaminants that are in your paint and or on your wheels from your brakes. You're going to start with your wheels and you're going to spray them down liberally. Once they're fully saturated, you can move on to the body. This is not a necessary step, but it's good if your car is brand new or has been on the road for a long time. You're going to let this sit on the car for about 2 to 5 minutes. I would not recommend doing this in direct sunlight or if it's hot out, as if you let it sit for too long or it dries, it can stain the paint. But once the solution turns purple, you're going to know it's doing its job. You're going to let it turn purple, you're going to let it start to dry out, not fully, and at that point you want to rinse it very well. You're going to rinse from the top and work your way down. This way you'll ensure that most, if not all, contaminants are removed before washing the car. Step 2 is going to be using a foam cannon. A foam cannon is not necessary, but it's definitely ideal if you have access to one. The foam helps loosen up large dirt particles and contaminants, and it'll help to avoid swirling during hand washing. It also neutralizes any remaining de-ironing solution. In our foam cannon, we'll be using a pH neutral soap. This is a pink car soap, also from 3D Detailing. You're gonna saturate the car with the foam and let it sit for 2 to 5 minutes. And once that's done, you're gonna rinse it thoroughly. Step 3 is gonna be the hand wash. For this, we'll be using a two bucket method. In your first bucket, you'll have a pH neutral soap. In your second bucket, you will have clean water. In each bucket, you will have a grit guard at the bottom. This is to prevent your wash mitt from touching the bottom of the bucket where dirt may collect. We will be using a microfiber style wash mitt. You're going to wash one panel at a time, making sure that you dunk your wash mitt into your clean water in between each panel. The purpose of this is to clean off the wash mitt from any dirt to prevent any swirling. When washing, make sure you just let the mitt glide over the panel. You don't want to apply any excessive pressure. Work from the top, work your way down, and once you're done, rinse thoroughly. Step 4 is going to be washing the wheels. Once you're done washing the car, take a clean microfiber cloth and submerge it in your soap bucket. Gently go over the wheels and make sure to regularly clean the cloth when dirt starts to accumulate. Go over all the wheels and rinse thoroughly once you're done. Step 5 is going to be drying. We're going to use a water blade for the glass only. The reason for that is that you can scratch your paint with it. You're going to use a large clean microfiber drying towel for the painted surfaces. For top facing panels, we're going to drape the towel over the car and lightly drag it to dry. For all other panels, we're going to fold the towel to make sure the seams are not exposed. We're going to lightly wipe the panels, avoiding any excess pressure. Lastly, we're going to use a clean microfiber cloth to dry the wheels. This is to avoid any water spotting. If you follow these few simple steps, your car will stay looking new for a long time. Thank you for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.